Okay friends, let us start the second phase of the third module. We have already seen how mailing process takes the advantage of every layer, and we'll continue further. And there is a very critical point. The point is the path of the sender may be different than the receiver. Try to see, this is a sender. You can see that it travels a path which is not the same as the receiving path possible. The other critical thing is that the mail communication that we talked about is asynchronous. Point is, why? Because the sender and the receiver may not be online at the same point in time. Okay. And that is the reason why there is an intermediary involved in the mailing process. So, let the sender or receiver may not be online at the same point of time, whenever, but the intermediary is always online. So, what will happen when the sender sends the mail, it is received by the intermediary and stored in the mailbox. We have already seen that. Now, whenever receiver expects the mail, it is delivered to it. Okay. So, this is two step AC process or two tier model, which is very critical. When we look at SMTP later, we will see how these things are carried out, but this is only a small idea about how that happens. And we are at the moment, we are only talking about the first case. When we talk about SMTP, we are only talking about sender to intermediary communication and not further. Now, we look at the other protocol called HTTP. Okay. HTTP is a little different than mail. There are few things which are similar, so we will skip that, but whatever is different, we will be discussing. Okay. So, there are two examples, www.google.com and www.espninfo. creekinfo.com and a few other things which are part of it. Okay. Protocol is indicated by either HTTPS or HTTP. Okay. The other part, www.google.com or espninfo.com, is domain name. In case number 1 on the left hand side, Google, okay, we do not have anything after google.com, but in the other case we have a directory and a typical JSON file under it, which is already provided. Okay. What does this do? Once you type HTTP on the URL of your browser, the browser, remember, it converts this into application specific command. So, we will convert this into /http/1.1 and something. You may not know what is this, but it is basically an application specific command called HTTP header and HTTP body and so on and so forth. Okay. In the other end, you can see both cases, different GET statements, different GET commands are constructed. Once that is done, and if it is missing, there are few things which are missing, then it is added. In case of left hand side, www.google.com, maybe something called default.html is added at the end. Okay. In the right hand side case, you have explicitly specified, so it's not going to do. Okay. And the last thing, the browser requests a DNS to get the IP address. Remember, this is something which you have already seen before. The HTTP header is created with data being the remaining part. This guess HTTP 111 and all that is basically HTTP header. The header and the IP address is passed to the TCP. Remember, this is something that we have not seen before. The HTTP gets the IP address. HTTP is not going to use it. It passes to TCP. Even TCP is not going to use it. The IP, the next layer, is going to use it. So, it is continue to pass till the IP layer receives it. Okay. Choosing a receiver process. Now, that is very critical. Once you do this, okay, you decide the sender, www.google.com and whoever, you know that it is HTTP. So, you will be using something called port number 80. If you are sending a mail, you will use 25, and remember, the receiver is going to learn about what is being sent based on this value. Okay. So, how TCP processes it? So, TCP decides the port number 80, means it decides that the receiver is going to be a web server. So, IP address of the receiver passed from the DNS is passed with it. Remember, TCP is not going to do anything with this IP address, is passed further. Now, TCP constructs its own header with respective port number. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4 is sender's port number, 80 is the receiver's port number, and the rest of the content is not shown. But this thing is called connection request. Remember, TCP is connection oriented. It begins with connection request and send it across further. But after the connection is established, we'll send data as well, the other content of the header. Okay. But now it contains something called HTTP request. HTTP request contains HTTP header and a few other things, and it will get HTTP response back. We will not be talking about that right now. When we talk about application layer HTTP, we will see exactly what happens. Okay. Okay. And it is sent to IP layer. Now, IP processing happens. Now, TCP has given this thing to IP. So, what does it do? IP now receives that destination IP address. Remember, that was started from DNS to TCP, now it is given to IP. IP is actually going to process this. Okay. So, what does it do? It looks at the routing table it has and find out, remember, from destination IP address, it finds out the next immediate neighbor's IP address. Now, these are two different things. 101010, that is shown as a symbolic fashion, normally addresses are much longer, is basically servers, HTTP servers, web servers IP address. Looking at that value from routing table, it gets the next immediate router's IP address. Now, very critical process. Okay. So, what does it do? It finds, it writes receiver's IP address, sender's IP address, other parts of the header, and the from TCP, it picks up the TCP segment. Now, this entire thing is called a packet. Now, what data link layer has to do? So, there is a difference. IP layer, IP address is a global address, which is unique across internet or global. So, they are not going to change. Unlike that, the physical layer address or the data link layer address is a local address. Okay. It may or may not, but normally not unique. Okay. The physical address represents the network. Okay. IP address represents the entity. Okay. So, this is something which is very critically important. So, what we need to do basically, we have a data link, we have a network address, the receiver's network address. Now, we need to actually construct a frame. So, when I am using an Ethernet card, I have to construct an Ethernet frame. But then Ethernet frame will have to have a MAC address or a physical address, which is a local address. Okay. And these are the issues that I have to face. Now, this value, this is called MAC address. So, point is, when I am sending frame across, I need to convert 172.16.254.1 into 0017 4F 085D 69. Now, that is done by something called address resolution process, which converts IP address into this address. Okay. Now, remember, this is the job. Okay. Receiver's IP address to receiver's MAC address. Once that is done, the frame is constructed, okay, which contains receiver's MAC, sender's MAC, other part of the header, IP header, IP packet, and trailer. And now that frame is sent. Physical layer's job. Okay. Physical layer sends the frame over the wire, same thing, bit by bit to the other end, converts. Please understand, for physical layer, you can see that the frame is only a sequence of bits. It does not really know what is MAC, what is packet, what is trailer. It will only understand that these are the bits which I need to send across. It only converts these bits into signals and send them across. It does not really know what each bit mean. Okay. So, the next destination physical address. So, the job of physical layer is to send. Okay. Friends, in the second phase, we have seen very, very critical part of data communication process. We have seen how HTTP works, but then we have already seen how SMTP works. We have seen something further here. We have seen how HTTP manages multiple web servers. In fact, how it converts the URL that you type into something called HTTP request, and how it is being sent and processed. So, with that, we conclude this second phase. We will continue further in the third phase, and we will look at how this both protocols actually are carried out, in fact, by all these layers together. We have already seen, but then we are going to talk more about them.